Good morning, students. We can start our moral science class, chapter 3, honesty. And we can see what is the honesty. Honesty means to be truthful for a person in all the aspects of life. The honesty means it is saying to be truthful, a person should be truthful in the all the aspects of life. He have to be truthful in the all the aspects of life, and it involves not to tell lie to anybody, and it is involving not to never say the lie to anyone, always saying the truth, and never hurt anyone through bad habits, activities or behavior, and never hurting anyone through our bad habits or the activities or the behavior, and never saying the lie. Always we should say the truth, and this is the meaning of honesty. Honesty means that we have to be truthful in all the aspects of life, and we never say the lie. Always we have to say the truth and never hurt any person or any people through our bad activities or our behavior and through the our bad habits. Never hurt anyone. And we can see how should be an honest person. The honest person never involved in the activities that are morally wrong. What are the activities it is morally wrong? Never involved in that. And not breaking any rule and regulations. Always doing or practicing the rules and regulations, and never breaking the rules and regulations. And be disciplined. The honest person always will be disciplined and behaving well. The honest person will behave very well and speaking the truth. The honest person always he will say the truth, not saying the lie. Always he will say the truth and being punctual. Always he will be punctual. The honest person always will be punctual and helping others honestly, and very honestly he will help others. These are the qualities or the things we can find out from a honest person. Once more, never involved in the activities that are morally wrong, and not breaking any rule and regulation, be disciplined, behaving well, speaking the truth, being punctual, helping others honestly. These are the qualities we can find out from an honest person. And we can see in your textbook there is a story. You can listen to the story now. Everyone knew that Shruti was the best speller in the whole class. The Shruti, one student, she was the best speller in the whole class. And she could spell difficult words like encyclopedia and amendment very easily. What are the difficult words also she can spell very easily. She used to get perfect scores during each weekly spelling test, and each weekly spelling test whenever conducting, Shruti is getting the good score. Miss Daisy, her English teacher, made a rule for the spelling test that any child who does not get at least 60% correct spelling would have to copy each word 50 times for next week's spelling test. Then their English teacher, she made that a rule. Those who are not getting at least 60% correct spelling in the spelling test, they have to write for the next time, they have to write each word, they have to write 50 times. This is the rule made by the teacher. And Sonam, who sat next to Shruti, always struggled in spelling. Then Shruti is a best one to spell the words, and one who is sitting near to her, Sonam, she is struggling to write the spellings. Last Thursday, she received 56%, which meant copying each word 50 times. Then last time Sonam got only 56% and she had to write all the word in 50 times. Shruti was so confident in her spelling abilities that she had felt and decided not to study for her next spelling test. And Shruti was very confident because before previous times and all, whenever conducting the test, she is getting the good mark, she is scoring the good mark, and this time she was very confident and she decided that not to study. The test began. Miss Daisy pronounced each word and then repeated it. Everything was okay until she spoke handkerchief, and Shruti was written everything what the teacher said until the handkerchief. Shruti scribbled H A N D K E R C H Now what? I or E? Her mind was blank and she got confused. The last letters I or E have to write. She got the confused because she did not. She was very confident and she did not get the spelling. Miss Daisy started to move on to the next word. It occurred to Shruti that Sonam knew how to spell it. Sonam had written this word 50 times. And Shruti know that the Sonam, she is knowing this word spelling because last time she has written this word 50 times. There was wide open space between Shruti and Sonam. Shruti's eyes rolled to the right. There it was spelled out in Sonam's handwriting. Her eyes went quickly back to her own paper and finished the word with the letters I, E, F. And Shruti, she saw the Sonam's paper and she got the correct spelling and she returned in her paper the correct spelling of the handkerchief. Shruti remained tense and nervous as Miss Daisy read the last spelling word. And now Shruti was very tensed and nervous because she had cheated just for the first time in her life. In her life, she is teaching the first time because always she is studying and writing or writing the correct spelling. This time she did not get one word spelling and she was cheated. And when she cheated this time, she was very tensed and she was very nervous. She thought, is this the way I want to keep my perfect record by being a cheater? And she realized that it is not the way to get a good record or to get the good score. It is not the things to do the cheating. Frantically, she realized what she had written earlier and replaced it with what she knew was the wrong answer. And what she did, soon she took the eraser and she erased the correct spellings because and she wrote the wrong answer what she knew. She wrote E-I-F. As her sweetie hand released pencil and passed the test up to the front, she sighed with relief. She thought, so what if my perfect scores are no longer intact? At least my honesty is. At last she realized that it is not getting the good mark or scoring the mark without having the honesty. We have to be honest always. There is a saying, honesty is the best policy, and honesty is the best policy in our life. No dishonesty, ask dishonesty and repent for it. And if we are knowing the dishonesty, what we have to do? We have to repent for that. Without doubt, one who repents is an honest person, and one who is repenting, if doing the dishonest, and if we are repenting for that, we are the honest person. And without honesty, one cannot make a trustworthy relationship with family, friends, teachers, etc. in any situation. Honesty builds trust in her relationship. And if we are the honest person, we will have the trust in our relationship with the parents or the teachers and the elders and all. And we can see here something, why it is important to be honest. Why it is important to be honest. And the first thing it is saying, honesty fosters courage. The honesty, it is giving the courage, or when we are doing the honesty, it is growing within us the courage. And honesty shows you care. The honesty will show you to care others, and it will show that care. And honesty creates a circle of love. And if you are having the honest, if you are an honest person, it is creating the love within us. And honesty shows the maturity and self-acceptance. And the honesty is showing the maturity. We will be a mature person and the self-acceptance also. And honesty can keep you out of trouble. The honesty will make us to get rid of all the troubles from us. These are the things we can see, the importance to be honest. And we can see, honesty is a good habit which gives everyone a happy and peaceful mind. Dishonesty never let any relationship to grow and creates lots of problems. And honesty is the thing, it is having the, we will be very happy and we will have the peaceful mind in our life. And if you are the dishonest person, it is not giving the relationship to grow and creates, it is creating lots of problem. And we have to be always honest person. It is a quality which can be developed anytime. However, practice, one should do it from the early childhood with the help of parents, grandparents, teachers and neighbors. And we have to grow the honesty from where? From our parents and grandparents and the teachers and from the neighbors. We have to realize, we have to grow the honesty. The childhood onwards, we have to grow in honesty. And it is very important to be honest in all the aspects of the contributes positively a lot throughout the life. And it is the important things we have to show that in all the aspects of our life we have to show the honest. If you are the honest person, what will happen? We will be always happy and we can do all the things very well. So it is not saying the lie or not doing, not hurting anyone. We have to say always the truth and we have to be honest person in all our aspects of life. So you have to try to be in the childhood onwards, you have to try to be honest person and do the things very properly, and you have to say always truth, not saying the lie. Always we have to be you have to say the truth in your life. So all of you, I think all of you understood, and try to be honest person. Thank you.